Welcome to WebStarPress. In this video, we are going to create drop-down date and date range select. We have created three variations that are easy to build and meet requirements for most of the projects. These are highly customizable and easy to use. I have used inputs in examples, but you can use simple divs instead of inputs. It is React.js and we have important things stored in state anyways. So use input or div as you like, it doesn't matter. React date select, React date range select, and React date range picker. Clicking at input opens dropdown with calendar. We can select any date. We can select the month. We can select year. And on clicking outside of this calendar closes the dropdown. Also on pressing escape key closes dropdown as well. This was simple date select. And this is date range select. And this is even more advanced React date range picker. This is a comprehensive and flexible date and date range select for your React projects. In case of date range selection, we have the start date and end date separately also. Here you see these both in input, but we can have these separately as well. We are not bound by anything while using these date select and date range select utilities. Let's build these. We are going to use a package to create these. This is React date range. It offers stateless date operations. It's highly configurable, has multiple range selections. It's based on native JS dates, offers drag and drop date selections, and it's keyboard friendly. Go to its live demo, and here you will find everything that you will need. It requires CSS files for styling these two CSS files. We will install it like this, npm install React date range. And most importantly, it offers four standalone components: date range picker, calendar, defined range. We can use any of these depending on project requirement. Everything is here. For example, if you want to use date range picker, we will import date range picker from React date range. And here is the code to implement it. We'll also use a package datefns to format date and to add days in our date range. Datefns is like Lodash for dates. And here this component will be used, date range picker, and here are the options. Datefns or date functions, the package is this one. So let's install our dependencies to create these. npm install React date range. And then npm install datefns. Okay, dependencies installed. Start the app. One more thing, I have small CSS code here. Input styling, same styling can be used for the div if you don't want to use input. Calendar wrap for mainly position relative. This is outer container. Calendar element. This is actual element that is using absolute position. It will hold the calendar element or calendar or date picker. Okay, let's create a component for our first example. New folder, components, new file, calendar component .jsx, React arrow function, export component, save, and here import calendar component from components calendar component.jsx. Okay, import use effect, use ref, use state from React, import calendar from React date range, and import format from date FNS format. Then we will use two CSS files that are required by React date range. We are going to use this calendar component for the state, const calendar set calendar use state empty. Here the date will be stored. Clause for the main div is calendar wrap. And here is calendar component date, class name calendar element, and on change handle select. Handle select. It will take an argument date, and here we will set the state. But before that, let's see what we have got in date. Console.log date. Save. And here we have got the calendar. Inspect console. And if we click at the date, we've got the date like this. This is not usable. We need its simple version. So console log format date, and we are going to use date format like this. Save. And now if we click add the date, we need this kind of formatted date. Now we can store this in state, and then we can use input here and use its value to be this calendar from state. It should be read only, and it has a class input box. So we have the date here, but if we refresh the page on load, I want to display the date here on page load as well. So I will use effect hook and set the date in state in this format, but current date. Now when this component will be loaded, current date will be stored in state and it will be displayed here in input. Refresh, and we have got the date. And when we click add the calendar, the date will be changed. Now this is done, and now we want to close this calendar. If I click outside, this calendar should be closed. So we create another state. Open close const open set open, and its value is false. It is a boolean value. It will be false or true. If it will be true, then we want to show this calendar. Open and this calendar. Save. So the value is false by default, so it is hidden. If I use true here, save, it is displayed. False, and it is hidden. Now I want to display it by clicking at this input box. That is easy. For our input, on click, set open, not open, save. Basically, we are toggling this state here. Click and it is opened. And the date is being changed. and now we have to close it when we click outside of this calendar. Refresh, click, it is opened. So to close it, I want to add event listeners. Number one, if I click escape key, it should be closed. Number two, if I click outside, it should be closed. So in our use effect, here are two event listeners. Number one is key down and number two is click. At key down, we are triggering this function, hide on escape. And at click, we will check if the click is outside of this calendar, and then we will do something. Hide on escape. And this will be hide click outside. Hide on escape will take an event as parameter, and it will check if event.key is equal to escape set open false. Save console log e dot key. Let's see. Escape and it is closed. Inspect console asdf escape opened escape and it closed. Now to detect outside click, we will have to use useRef. Const ref1, this is the name. UseRef, initially it will be null. And here, console log ref1.current. Let's see. Inspect console null. It will also take an event. Event target. Body, app, this calendar. Now we have got the target. If ref1.current and not ref1.current dot contains e.target, set open false. So if reference is not this calendar, if click target does not contain this div, then close it. So we'll have to define this one. And here we will create a div ref ref. This is our ref one, and we'll put the whole thing inside it. So this is our reference. If calendar will be clicked, calendar will not close. But if click event will not contain this reference, then calendar will be closed. Refresh, opened, escape closed, opened. And if we click here, nothing happens. If we select the date, date is being changed and nothing happens. But if we click outside of this calendar, then it will be closed. Okay, that's it for this example. It was the React date select. Let's create these two. I will create two more components. Date range component dot JSX. And date range picker component dot JSX. I will just copy this whole thing, paste it here and paste it here. Here name will be changed, export name will be changed. For this one, component name will be changed, export name will be changed. and here three components. Save. Okay, so let's change this second one, date range component. Here we will need add days from date FNS, and also instead of calendar we will use date range. So here we will have date range, and for the date state we will use this range and set range, and here this array, and options will be start date, end date, and key. We won't need this thing here. We won't need handle select for this one. And then for the options, on change item, set range, item dot selection, editable date inputs true. Move range on first selection false, ranges range month 1, direction horizontal, and same class name. And now for the value for the input, we will use template literal. Here this is first variable, 2 this second variable. Now in this state we have got start date and end date. So here format range 0 dot start date, and for the format we will use this format. Similarly, end date will be like this. Save. This is a start date. And this is end date, and there is 7 days gap between them. Click. And it is working perfectly. Also, we can change it from the options. We can use 2 months. Save, and now these are 2 months. We can use vertical, and now these are vertical. But we'll prefer 1 for this example. Simple calendar. And here date range from start to finish. Both dates are being changed, start date and end date. So this example is also done with a little bit of change. Okay, so I'll just take this second example and paste for the third example, because third is similar to second one, and I'll just change the name for the component and change the name in export as well. Now instead of date range for the third example, we will use date range picker, and here date range picker. And here we will use 2 and horizontal, and that's it. And look at that. Dates here are being changed. This is the input area where dates are being changed. And we can select yesterday, today, this week, this month, last month, or custom range. And these are all working. Escape. Without any console errors. Refresh. Okay, three different components using React date range. I will share the code in description as well, so check that out. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.